لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت ذي العزة والجبروت ذي الفضل والكرم ذي القدرة والنعم. الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام، عزيز لا يضام، قهار لا يرام. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Fear Allah as he should be feared, and dare not except on the state of Islam. May Allah the Most Merciful grant us this great gift to die on the state of Islam. Allahumma ameen ya arhamar rahimeen. Amma ba'd. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Maidah: قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ نُورٌ وَكِتَابٌ مُبِينٌ يَهْدِي بِهِ اللَّهُ مَنِ اتَّبَعَ رَضْوَانَهُ سُبُلَ السَّلَامِ وَيُخْرِجُهُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَيَهْدِيهِمْ إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. This ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking to the people of the book, that mainly for the believer, because this ayah is in the Quran, is indeed came to you a light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكِتَابٌ مُبِينٌ, and a clear sign, a clean book, the scripture that it has everything that someone needs in his life. And in this book, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described everything, and he said that whoever who seeking his pleasure, he'll guide him to the ways of peace. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lead him out from darkness to the light by his will. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide him to the right path. And in this ayah, you see there's four elements. The first element is Al-Hadi, the guide. The second, in the tool of the guidance, which is the Quran, يَهْدِي بِهِ وَهُوَ الْكِتَابُ وَالنُّورِ. And the third element is how to be candidate to be one allowed or to have the gift of the guidance. قَالَ مَنِ اتَّبَعَ رُبْوَانَ. And the fourth element, which is the fruit and the bliss of the guidance, يَهْدِي بِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى سُبُلَ السَّلَامُ وَيُخْرِجُهُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ وَيَهْدِيهِمْ إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Those are four elements. The guide Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent out the Quran as a tool of the guidance, that he will guide and benefit whom who will seek in the pleasure of Allah, that in the condition, and then he will have all the bliss of the guidance, which in the fulfillment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, which one of them the greatest is to be guided to the way of peace, and the way of peace are the way to Allah, the way to the Jannah, the way to the pleasure of Allah, the way to be saved from the torment of the hellfire. After Ramadan, every one of us was very busy with the Quran. What is your state today with the Quran? We've been reading the Quran in the day and standing with the Quran in the night. What is your state today with the Quran? It's not the Quran that to be read only in Ramadan, but the Quran, it is alive as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned. And if someone is far from the Quran, is actually from the equation of the four elements that we mentioned, there is something very true, and it is the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you want the guidance, if you want the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you need first to seek the pleasure of Allah. But in the sign for us to be really seeking and truly and sincerely seeking the pleasure of Allah, that you are close to the book of Allah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the ayah, قَالَ يَهْدِي بِهِ مَنِ اتَّبَعَ رَضْوَانَ. So whoever who seeks the pleasure of Allah, he is close to the Qur'an. And the one who is really far from the Qur'an, he only seeking the pleasure of Allah by pretending by his tongue, but not by his heart. No. Because someone when he is far from the Qur'an, he is deserting the Qur'an. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described for us the torment of those deserters of the Qur'an. قَالَ وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا يَا وَيْلَتَى لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِي. The dhikr is the Quran. And the day when the man will bite, the transgressor will bite on his hand, on his finger, say, I wish I took with the way, the way with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I wish I didn't take so and so as a friend. He misled me from the dhikr from the Quran. And after this ayah, look Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what he said. قَالَ وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. And behold, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Oh Allah, oh my Lord, my people, they have deserted the Quran. Their fact, to desert the Quran, to know what it means, hajara, is to cut off the relation with the Quran, to not have a relation with the Quran. So if someone doesn't have a relation with the Quran after Ramadan, he's not truly seeking the pleasure of Allah. Because if he seeks the pleasure of Allah, he will have the relation of the Quran with the Quran for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide him, and he give him the result and the bliss of the guidance of the Quran. And the Mufassirun, they're saying the deserting of the Qur'an, it has different meaning. Deserting of the Qur'an is to not read the Qur'an for a month or more. Deserting of the Qur'an is to not implement the Qur'an. But in fact, there's people who read the Qur'an, but they are deserting the Qur'an. And those people who think that they are implementing the law of the Qur'an, but they don't behave with the moral of the Qur'an. But if you look at this reality and this massive distraction around us, how can a believer after Ramadan to keep that relation with the Quran, which is really a testimony and witness for him that he's truly seeking the pleasure of Allah? And he doesn't want to end up like the one transgressor described in Surah Al-Furqan. He will be biting around his finger. He said, I wish I took away with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is something that we need to reflect on within the world of the Quran, the universe of the Quran, the reality of the Quran. The Quran has a reality. The Quran has a world that he invites us to live in like this world. And subhanAllah, when you read the Quran and you look around you, you feel like you're a stranger. Or if you are associated and attached to the world of sight, you feel like the Quran is something strange, talking about something not related to your life. And this is actually the problem that someone needs to reflect on and bring back himself, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَنِيبُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُ لَهُ. And then he said, قَالَ وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ رَبِّكُمْ. Come back to Allah and submit to him and follow what the best that Allah revealed, it is the Quran. So when you look at the Quran, you find totally different word, totally different description from outside what we have. There, when the believer look at the Quran and he understand the universe of the Quran, the reality of the Quran, then he will look at the reality outside from the way of the Quran, from the filter of the Quran. That's how we keep. Then you find the need for the Quran to be the nourishment of your soul, to be the light of your guidance, of your path. That's when you need, you find the need of the Quran. You cannot be away from the Quran, because in the Quran you're gonna find your comfort. In the Quran you're going to find your guidance. In the Quran you're going to find your reality. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, yeah, you are a stranger. Gharib, because the Islam started gharib and ended by being gharib. You are gharib, how you can find yourself in your own reality when you go back to the Quran? That's why, according to this reality, when you have close relation with the Quran, when you understand that you live with the universe of the Quran, and we'll understand it in a very few words, inshallah ta'ala, will explain it. So when you leave the universe of the Quran, that you feel that you are in need of the Quran. You are in need to read it in the morning. You are in need to recite it during the day. You are in need to read it in the night. Why? Because it is the substance of your life that is the Quran. Then you make yourself far from those who Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam talking about to say they deserted the Quran. Ya qawmi inna qawmi ittakha, ya rabbi inna qawmi ittakha hadha al-Quran mahjura. Looking at the word of the Quran, subhanAllah, you can define the people in three categories. The first category of the people, they live double life with the Quran. A lifestyle they choose for themselves and they pray and they get whatever they want. And then when you come to the season, religious season, or they come to the environment of religious environment like the masjid, they become close to the Quran. Outside this environment or this time, they are far from this Quran. And these people, when they are very close to Allah, they are only for themselves. Because they have a problem of income, they come back to Allah. Allah, give us income. When they have a difficulty, they come back to Allah. So they don't worship Allah for the sake of Allah. They worship Allah for the sake for themselves. These people, they live a double life. يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى حَرْفِ. He's praying Allah or worshipping Allah on edge.
the second category of the people who they already have a way of life. And they want to use the Quran to validate their way of life. They make a false interpretation and in a way to validate their way of life. And these people, Ashabul Nahwa, these people are far from Allah. These people like the secular people who want to make the Quran like submit to their way of life and the life of what they choose for themselves, not the life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala govern for them or describe for them. These type of people, what some of them, they call them the new Muslim thinkers. When you think or you hear this word, the new Muslim thinkers, all those people who want to deprive and take away from the Quran His holiness, that is from Allah, and He says a text that you need, you can criticize and also comment the text in a way that you can accept some of it and reject some of it. This is the second category, wal-iyadu billah, those are mardoon, those are deviated. The third category, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَالَ وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَنِيبُوا, come back to Allah, وَأَسْلِمُوا, their full submission to the teaching of the Qur'an. You come to the Qur'an, you say, Ya Allah, help me understand it. Ya Allah, help me reach what you want me to achieve into through your command, Ya Allah. These are the people that they live in the Qur'an. They look at the universe, and this is how what we describe in the universe of the Qur'an in a three aspects. The first aspect, they look at this whole existence, not segmented life, is one life. A life of today of planting and investing, and a life of tomorrow of reaping and harvest. It's well-connected lives. There is no gap between them. It's one life. You live here, the death is a transition, you find yourself in the day of judgment, that in the word of the Quran. The second thing, that when you look at the word of the Quran, you find full coherence between the action of the man and the whole universe around us, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the righteousness, it is the true condition of the well-being of the whole universe. This is the truth in the universe of the Quran. It requires a lot of understanding, but just today, Ikhwani and dear respected sister, to come for us to reflect, invite ourselves to reflect, to not desert the Quran, because the Quran is the whole world, is the whole reality, is the whole universe that we need to live and implement in our life. The second, the third aspect is in the universe of the Quran, is to look at yourself, the dignity that you have. This great honor that Allah gave you is not a dignity that you gain by certain nationality. It's not a dignity that you gain by the accumulation of the belonging of the dunya. It's a dignity that Allah gave it to you. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blew in the Adam, in the status of Adam, or in the shape of Adam, the soul, قَالَ فَإِذَا نَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ. And all the malaika prostrated to Adam, honoring this new creation who are you. And the dignity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to the human being, that He made them to be carried in the land and in the sea. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everything around us for us. وَالَّذِي خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا. That the dignity, you find it in the Quran, do not find your dignity outside. If you do like that, someone end up, وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ loser. قَالَ أَيَبْتَغُونَ عِنْدَهُمُ الْعِزَّةِ فَإِنَّ الْعِزَّةَ لِلَّهِ جَمِيعًا. Are they seeking the might and the pride from other? Indeed, the izzah is belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the last aspect, it is to look at your ancestors, to look at your kinship, who are these great people. It's not a lineage that someone connected with his blood, no, for the believer, his kinship. The ancestor of the believers, they long rooted in the history. You look at Adam alayhi salam, Nuh and his people, Yusuf and his people, Yaqub and his people, Ibrahim alayhi salam, wa Musa wa Isa, those are the ancestors of the believers. When you look at the universe of the Quran, that's your family. When your family, you see your family, how they were facing the difficulty, they are talking in history, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَكَذَلِكَ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الرُّسِلِ مَا نُثَبِّتُ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ. We're relating for you the story of the Prophet to help you strengthen your heart. And this is how the believer, when we dig in the universe of the Quran. This is the universe of the Quran. You don't find in the universe of the Quran such a thing that is being read. In the Quran you find Fir'aun al-Tari. Outside the Quran you find Fir'aun. It was a great empire when they have this great monument. In the Quran you find who is the loser. And the Quran describes for you how people are screaming in hellfire. In the news you don't see anything of that except injustice. That's why when someone lives in the universe of the Quran, he understands his need of the Quran. He understands his relation of the Quran. And those who live the way of the Quran when they hear it is increase their iman. The Quran when they hear it increase their trust in iman. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. The true believers are those when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned, their heart is filled with fear. And when they hearing the recitation of the Quran, it increase their iman. And they put their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those are the true believers. One of the great tabi'in started by being a captive from Persia. And he ended up a servant where in al-Basra. He accepted Islam and he was a true believer and he memorized the Quran. He used to be a servant working a hard day and in the night they finished the whole Quran. In the night that he finished the whole Quran, it was very, very hard for them. He started mushrik, non-believers. This is the word of the Quran. And then when he met the companions of Allah Ta'ala alayhim, he asked them, what should they do? It's very hard, we work so hard. They told them, you need to finish the Quran in 7 days. He said, when we start to do it in 7 days, we find for ourselves a time to read it and contemplate the Quran. And then he ended up to be a servant as a lady, an honorable lady for Bani Tamim. And he learned the Quran, and he learned the writing, and he learned the hadith because she wasn't giving him a lot of work. So he was dedicating his free time in learning more the Quran. And came one time, he went to the Jumu'ah with her, and she came after Jumu'ah to say, look, I witness you that I give a freedom to this young man. I give him a freedom to be for me and a great investment, inshallah, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Day of Judgment. This man is one of the great tabi'in of al-muqri'in, Abu al-Aliyah Faraj ibn Mihran. Abu al-Aliyah. This is a great man that he started the mushrik not knowing anything and he ended up by being one of the great muqra. He finished the Quran on Ubay ibn Ka'ab and Ibn Abbas wa Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and he heard the hadith from Umar ibn al-Khattab wa Ali ibn Abi Talib wa Abi Dharr radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. Abu al-Aliyah, he was teaching his people and his students the word of the Quran. He told them, do you know, when you understand and you read the Quran, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decree on himself, whoever believe in Allah, Allah will guide him. وَمَنْ يُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِي قَلْبَهِ. Allah will guide his heart. He said, do you know, whoever who trusts in Allah, it will be Allah enough for him and sufficient. قَالَ رِيدْ وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. Whoever trusts Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is enough for him. And he said, whatever someone loan to Allah, Allah will reward them tremendously. رِيدْ فَمَنْ الَّذِي يُقْرِضُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا فَيُضَاعِفَهُ لَهُ أَضْعَافًا كَثِيرًا. Whoever will loan Allah a good loan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiply for him. And he said, whoever who call Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answer him. قَالَ وَسَرِيدْ وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. All those are the word of the Quran to keep the believer close to the Quran. And this great man, one time with the word of the Quran, how he became trusting in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to come to high level. He subhanahu wa ta'ala, he was suffering from a disease that is attack his bone of his leg and they have to cut off his leg. And they ask him, they need to give him some drug or sedative. And he said, I will not take such a thing. So he asked for a good reciter of the Quran to read in front of him the Quran. He said, when you see my face turn red and my eyes fix and look into the sky, do your job. Because he was in the word of Quran. He was embedded with the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After they cut off his leg, they told him he didn't feel anything. He said, قَالَ بَرْدُ حُبِّ اللَّهِ وَحَلَاوَةِ سَمَاعِ كِتَابِهِ أَذْهَبَتْ حَرَارَةَ لَذَّةِ النَّمَشِيرِ. The coldness that it comes with the love of Allah and the sweetness in listening the words of Allah overcome the pain of the saw that it was on my back. Dear brother, sister, this is the word of the Quran.
This is the word of the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gifted us. This is the word of the Quran that Allah brought us back to train and to taste in Ramadan. Do not lose the word of the Quran. Do not desert the Quran. The Quran, we need the Quran, not the Quran need us. The Quran is our life. The Quran is our reality. The Quran is our universe. If we don't find the need in the Quran, therefore we're not seeking the pleasure of Allah. That's what Allah said. If you are not attached to the Quran, really will not seek in the pleasure of Allah. Say, what is your purpose of Allah? Say, to please Allah. Are you attached to the Quran? Not really. You're not seeking the pleasure of Allah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala yahdi bihi man ittaba'a ridwan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to His ways and make the heart, the Quran to be the dearest to our heart. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا وَالْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. The effect of the Quran on the companion رضوان الله تعالى عليهم, it was an immediate effect. They lived with the Quran because it was their guidance, it was their source, it was their soul, it was their light. Thabit ibn Qais, he was the spokesperson of Al-Ansar. He had a high voice, loud voice. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the ayah in Surah Al-Hujurat, يَا أَيُّ الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا لَا تَرْفَعَ أَصْوَاتَكُمْ فَوْقَ صَوْتِ النَّبِيِّ وَلَا تَجْهَرُوا بِالْقَوْلِ كَجَهْرِ بَعْضِكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ أَنْ تَحْبَطَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. Oh, you believe, do not raise your voice above the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You're going to find out yourself that you lose all your deeds by respect to the greatness of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he heard that, he said, my voice is already loud. He once secluded himself in his house crying that he is from the people of Al-Fat. After a while, the Prophet ﷺ asked Sa'd ibn Mu'adh, قَالَ أَيْنَ ثَابِتْ. Where is Thabit? We didn't see him for a while. He said, I didn't know that he's sick. I will check on him. He went to him. And you know, he came out in tears. He told him, what happened to you? He said, I am from the people of Al-Fat. He said, why? Because I always raise my voice on the Prophet ﷺ. That is the effect of the Quran. That the effect of the Quran, when you read the Quran and you assimilate, you see yourself in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do not do this, and we read it and you pass over it without having any effect. This great companion, he didn't do it. Actually, he wasn't raising his voice, it's his nature. But because of the effect of the Quran, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in their abadim, in their soul, how he felt. So when Sa'd ibn Mu'adh came back to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, قَالَ أَخْبِرُهُ بَلْ هُوَ مِنْ أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ. Tell him, he is from the people of paradise. He is from the people of paradise. Our objective is not today how we're going to live. It's not tomorrow what type of income. Our objective is the universe of the Quran. Which type of face do you want to have? وُجُوهٌ خَاشِعَةٌ أَوْ وُجُوهٌ نَعِيمَةٌ وُجُوهٌ نَاظِرَةٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّنَا نَاظِرَةٌ أَمْ وُجُوهٌ بَاسِرَةٌ. Do you want frowny, dark face in the day of judgment, or joyful face looking to Allah? That is the universe of the Quran. That is the motivation and the dream that someone needs to have in the world of the Quran. And if we have this is truly strong in our heart, therefore you'll be very close to the Quran. As Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala said, he said, when you come to the Quran, bring all your heart together and have your ear to listen. And then try to imagine that Allah is speaking to you. Then the Quran, inshallah, will have an effect on you. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَذِكْرَ لِمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ قَلْبٌ أَوْ أَلْقَ السَّمْعَ وَهُوَ شَهِيدٌ. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه. اللهم ورنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها. أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم اجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا ونور أبصارنا وذهاب همومنا وجلاء أحزاننا وقائدنا وسالكنا إلى جناتك جنة النعيم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعل القرآن لنا في الدنيا قرينا واجعله لنا في القبر مؤنسا وعلى الصراط سالكا يا أكرم الأكرمين ويا أرحم الراحمين. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة يرحمكم الله.